Hi everyone, it's the Phantom. Today we have a little bit of a harder exponential equation problem. This one has been seen in a few of mathematical competitions all around the world. So this would be a good time to pause the video if you want to tackle this one for yourself. Okay, so first thing that we can notice in our exponential equation is that it has different bases for each term. This is not good because ideally you want to have the same base for every term in order to quickly and easily solve exponential equation. So let's take a look at the first term, 9 to the power of x. Here we will use the exponential rule that's called power to the power, that says that a to the power of b to the power of c is equal to a to the power of b times c. We will apply this to the 9 to the power of x. We can simplify the 9 as 3 squared, and using this rule we will get that the result is 3 to the power of 2x. We can do exactly the same thing for our third term, 4 to the power of x. If we apply this rule, we can simplify 4 as 2 squared, and in terms we will get that the result is 2 to the power of 2x. Now, if we take a look at our second term, 6 to the power of x, we can use another exponential rule that's called power of product. It states that a times b to the power of c is equal to a to the power of c times b to the power of c. We can apply this to the 6 to the power of x. We can simplify 6 as 2 times 3 and everything to the power of x, and we will get that that is 2 to the power of x times 3 to the power of x. Now, we can substitute these three values into our original equation, and we will get that 3 to the power of 2x plus 2 to the power of x times 3 to the power of x is equal to 2 times 2 to the power of 2x. Now, we will use this new equation to try to simplify things even more, because as you can see, we have two different bases now. That's good, but still we do not have one single base. And the secret here is to divide everything with the term that has the biggest exponent. That can be 3 to the power of 2x or 2 to the power of 2x. For this example, we will choose 2 to the power of 2x. So we will get the following in our left side and in our right side. Now we can simplify 2x and 2 to the power of 2x where we can, and we are left with 3 to the power of 2x over 2 to the power of 2x plus 3 to the power of x over 2 to the power of x, that equals to 2. Here we will use another exponential rule that's called power of quotient, that says a to the power of x over b to the power of x is equal to a over b to the power of x. If we apply this into our equation, we will get that 3 over 2 to the power of 2x plus 3 over 2 to the power of x is equal to 2. Now, as you can see, we have one common base. This is good. And now we will enter the substitution. We can say that 3 over 2 to the power of x is equal to t, and we will substitute that into our equation, and we get that t squared plus t is equal to 2, and if we rewrite this, we will get that t squared plus t minus 2 is equal to 0, and of course, this is a quadratic equation. There are a few different ways to solve quadratic equations, and in the future I will most definitely make a tutorial video about different ways how to solve them or how to factorize them. If I do make this video by the time that you watch this, I will make sure to put its link down in the description below, so please make sure to check it out. Alright, until then, we will use the most common method, and that is quadratic formula. So, just to remind ourselves, if we have a quadratic equation in a form of a times x squared plus bx plus c that equals to 0, we can use a quadratic formula minus b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. Now we will try to apply this into our equation. So, from our equation, we can see that the value of a, in our case, is equal to 1, value of b is also equal to 1, and the value of c is equal to minus 2. Now, we can substitute these values into our quadratic equation, and we will get that is minus 1 plus minus square root of 1 squared minus 4 times 1 times minus 2 over 2 times 1. We can simplify this to get minus 1 plus minus square root of 1 plus 8 over 2, and simplify it more, that's minus 1 plus minus square root of 9 over 2, and finally we will get minus 1 plus minus 3 over 2. From here we will have two possible solutions. First one will be minus 1 minus 3 over 2, that's minus 4 over 2, so the first solution is minus 2, and the second solution will be minus 1 plus 3, that is 2, over 2, that is 1. So, we have two possible solutions for t, minus 2 or 1. Now, we will substitute these values for t into our original substitution. And in our first case, we will get that 3 over 2 to the power of x is equal to minus 2. Here, we have a little bit of a problem, because 3 over 2 is a positive number, and since the base is positive, there is no value for the exponent that can make this a negative value in the solution. So that means that in this case we do not have solution for x. Now let's try the case number 2. In this one we have that 3 over 2 to the power of x is equal to 1. Here we can substitute value of 1 with 3 over 2 to the power of 0. Because, as you know, if the exponent is 0, then the result would be equal to 1. And from this, we can get that x is equal to 0, and this is our solution. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like, and see you all next time. Bye!